car teams tune their motors. Volume up.
Okay, I need you to start. The wife's outside. She hears this. She knows a little bit of the money I spent in this. Just start up and look like you're a better car than you are. Oh, you motherfucker. You fucking start. I spent every fucking dollar I have on you. You son of a bitch. You fucking start. You start, you piece of shit. I fucking hate this goddamn car. I hate this goddamn car. Wasted all my fucking money on this goddamn thing and it won't even... I fucking love this car. This is the best fucking things my hands have ever created.
Folks, I want to tell you a couple things about our national anthem. First and foremost, it is our national anthem. It's not just a song that celebrities show off on before a sporting event. It's not a political statement. In fact, our national anthem, folks, is the only national anthem in the world that is not a declaration of power or strength. Our national anthem is actually a question. And I'll bet you never thought about it before. But during the War of 1812, I'm going to give you a little history lesson here. There was a man named Francis Scott Keyes who wrote our national anthem. And he was actually a lawyer who was sent here to negotiate prisoners of war from Britain to America. There were prisoners of war in warships off the coast of Fort McHenry. And the admiral said, look, I'll do that. I'll negotiate with you and I'll give you your prisoners back one for one. We'll trade, but it really doesn't matter. And Francis Scott Key said, why is that? And he said, you see that flag over there at Fort McHenry? Let's look at Ken Schrader's flag. You see that flag at Fort McHenry? He said, yeah. And he said, well, we have ordered that flag to be taken down and replaced by our flag by sunset tonight. Or, he said, turn around. And on the horizon was every warship that Britain had. So we are going to open fire on that fort and obliterate that flag if they don't take it down. So when the question was asked, they fought all night. So the question was asked by the prisoners in the belly of the ship, hey, can you still see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming? So can you still see this morning what we were looking at as the sun was going down last night, which was that flag, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight or the ramparts we watched they were so gallantly streaming. So they were looking at that flag during the battle that was raging to tear it down over something kind of similar to this protected wall here. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. The only way during the night, because they didn't have this great lighting system, they could see that that flag was still there and that the people in Fort McHenry had not capitulated and given up their freedom, was by the light of the battle raging to tear it down. So it ends, oh say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave? Does it still wait?
Make your old dad proud.
I'll try.
Yep. Just bring her home safe. But you're somebody else.
And I can be the coolest guy in the world, but once I pull out there on the track, I'm gonna throw my nuts over my shoulder, skinny pedal down, and I'm gonna let her eat like an Ethiopian orphan out there at the buffet line. I'll be toting that left front wheel like an astronaut fart coming around the damn corner, man. Letting them know it ain't no bitch in my blood. We ain't leave the house, pawn all my granddad's guns, whore out my sister, and sell off all these pain pills to come in second.
Wait, SpongeBob! We're not cavemen! We have technology!
I'm a straight shooting, beer drinking, rule breaking, don't think I won't take a good thing.
What a fucking idiot I am. My wife's half naked and she says, come down and make me a margarita. And I'm like, baby, I gotta go work on that old dirt car, run granite.
When I pull up in the rear, baby, saying,
when you throw your nuts over your shoulder and let her eat like a fat girl at a buffet. It means a lot when a promoter does this.
Thanks for coming, man. I appreciate it. Thanks for everything.
We'll have more information about that tomorrow afternoon.
Men get so mad that we call them stupid, but in reality, if they would just take a fucking step back and listen.
Anyways, did you know that the 2.2 Ecotec from GM comes with a 12-to-1 compression stock, has a port injection fuel system, cam-driven power steering pump, and can run with no serpentine belt?
Where are you going? You're lost. Dollar Tree headset, so free, freer than a public restroom. You're literally dog water. Zero PR. Earnings check. Oh, will you have none?
Just got this thing ceramic coated and water don't even stick to it now.
Your son is racing without telling me your son is racing.
Thank you. it speaks. It's the rhythm that our souls seek. Laser beams and flashing lights, in the darkness we unite.